Let me just share screen and then we can all begin. Okay, I hope you can all see the screen. And yes, before we begin, I would like to start by, you know, introducing myself. So I am Sanchana and I am an IELTS trainer. And okay, so today we are going to discuss about the importance of time management in IELTS. As those of you, you know, who are aspirants of IELTS, I think you know how important time is. So today we are going to do a little, you know, detailed study on that. Okay. So, yes. Okay. Okay, we have somebody who has raised their hand. Yes, please tell me. Okay, so as we proceed, just keep your doubts to yourself, put them in the chat box. At the end, we'll have a little time where maybe you can, you know, discuss. You can ask me your doubts and I will clarify all of your doubts for you. Meanwhile, if there's anything, please just raise your hand. Or you can, you know, like I said, put it in the chat box and I will answer all of your questions. Yes. Okay. So now, how many of you are there? We have 6 of them. We wait for 2 more minutes and then we'll begin. Okay. Till we wait for, you know, the other participants, is there anything anybody would like to ask me? There's somebody has raised their hand. Please go ahead. Please unmute and speak. Please unmute and speak. Please unmute your audio. Prime.
Okay.
Yes. Hi.
Hi. I think I'll ask my question at the end of the session. You can go ahead.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Please do ask your question at the end of the session. Or you can also leave a note in the chat box. Even that should be okay.
Okay. It's fine. Thank you.
So, like we all know, time management is very crucial in the IELTS exam. So, your IELTS exam generally lasts for about 2 hours and 45 minutes, okay? The entire exam. And in this 2 hour 45 minutes, your IELTS reading, IELTS listening, IELTS writing takes up 2 hour 30 minutes, okay? So, this 2 hour 30 minutes is done in a single sitting on the same day. Okay, and the remaining 15 minutes is your speaking, which is done separately on another day. So this is how the pattern is. And I know sitting, you know, single sitting 2.5 hours can, you know, feel very intimidating. But with the right kind of practice, you know, we can, you know, ace the test. So you don't have to be very worried about it. The right kind of practice, the right strategies, it's very easy for you to, you know, manage your time. Manage that 2.5 hours. So, moving ahead. Yes, there's another thing that, you know, never sit for your IELTS exam without full preparation. Many people think it's just an exam. Let me just go give a try and then see if I can, you know, if I'm able to, you know, pass the exam or whatever. But please don't do that. Always prepare for your IELTS exam beforehand. And why I insist is, yes, it is important that you know what you're going to write, but it is also important that you know the time allotted for you. Without being sure of the time allotted for you, writing your exam is going to be really difficult. Okay? So understand the different timings allotted for different sessions. Once you're familiar with the test, and you have practiced a few times, then you can go absolutely stress-free, which is what we all want, right? Another thing is preparation time depends. Now, like I said, prepare and go. Not every student has the same preparation time, obviously. Your preparation time depends on your proficiency. Okay? Just a second. Yes. So preparation time depends on your proficiency. And by this, I mean that the more you are, you know, well-versed with your language, with your communication skills, the lesser time you will require to prepare. That's not a bad thing. It's okay if you require 2 to 3 months to prepare. And Red Fox Education provides different type of courses. From beginners to advanced, we have different courses for different people with different proficiency. I will be getting to that. Okay. So right now, we'll focus on, you know, the IELTS time management. And as we go ahead, I will tell you about the courses and the other things that we have. Yes. So moving ahead, one of the biggest mistakes, or one of the biggest, you know, errors that students tend to make is that they get exhausted, completely exhausted on their exam day. Now, exhaustion doesn't have to mean, you know, by traveling or, you know, by doing some intensive activity the previous day. Even if you study for, you know, a really long time the previous night, you are going to be exhausted the next morning. So never really study till the last minute. Do all your preparation, be prepared, and the previous day always, you know, take a break. Okay. Studying till the last minute just shows that you are not mentally ready to write the exam. So just be calm and stress-free the previous night at least. And the night when you're going to sleep, just, you know, sleep early and get a lot of sleep, and so that you can wake up stress-free. And when you go for the exam, you're really relaxed. So that is something that, you know, I would suggest all of you do. Now, for those of you who are new here, let's discuss about the different timings and the different aspects that is involved in each section of the IELTS exam. Now, like you all know, like you can see on the screen, IELTS has 4 sections. We have reading, writing, speaking, and listening. So now in this listening, writing, and reading are the sections that you will be doing on a single day. Yes. On one particular day, in a single sitting, it will be done. And your speaking will be done separately on a different day. So to begin with listening, listening has 40 questions. And these 40 questions are divided into 4 sections, which have to be answered in 30 minutes. So now, 30 minutes seems like a short time, but it'll be correct. You know, once you practice, you'll understand that 30 minutes is all you require. So in the first section, you'll have a recording where there'll be 2 speakers. It'll be a dialogue between 2 speakers. And then in the second section, you will have a single speaker. It'll be a monologue. Mostly it'll be, you know, travel guide speaking. Otherwise, somebody, you know, explaining about a museum, something like that. So that will be your section 2. Your part 2 in listening. And then in part 3, you will have 2 speakers again. No, in part 3, you will have a group discussion. Sorry, you will have a group discussion. Mostly this part 3 topic will be academic related. So you can, you know, prepare like that. You will hear a lot of academic related terms. And then your last part will have a single speaker who will explain about, you know, their project or their presentation. And then there might be some questions raised in between, but it will mostly be a single speaker speaking. Please be aware of the shift from one speaker to another. This is a place where many people, you know, lose, you know, track. A lot of different accents that will be in play. So try to concentrate, try to see who is speaking and try to differentiate between 2 different people speaking. And it is generally said that the last section is relatively difficult because it is a lecture. But generally in IELTS, the first sections are always easier than the last section. Okay. So after each section, you get a little time to prepare. This is for the first and the second and the third section. You get a little time to prepare for the next section. And in that time, you know, just go through the questions quickly. Use this time very wisely. Don't go through everything. Just read around the blanks so that you know what you're looking for, what you're searching for in the audio. Yes. So this is something that you all should keep in mind. And yes, out of 10 questions, like when I said 40 questions and 4 tasks, you will have 10 questions per task. And what you're supposed to do here is that in certain tasks, you will have 5 questions or 6 questions, and there'll be a break, and then you will have 4 questions. Otherwise, you will have 5 questions, a break, and then another 5 questions. But when it comes to task 4, you will have the entire 10 questions together. So please be prepared for that. Okay, so beforehand, just read the questions and train your mind to understand what you're looking for. Okay, even in listening, try to, you know, scan and skim. I know scanning and skimming are totally related to reading. They are skills that you require in the reading section, but it will be really advisable if you can use it for your listening section as well. Okay. So far, if there are any doubts, please drop them in the chat box. Yes. So then moving on to reading. So now reading again has 40 questions, but it doesn't have 4 sections. It has 3 sections. And the 40 questions is divided among these 3 sections. And you have 1 hour, that is 60 minutes to complete this. You might feel, okay, for listening, I got only half an hour. For reading, I'm getting 1 hour. Yippee, hooray, all of that. But then completing 40 questions in reading in 1 hour is a little challenging task. It's easy if you practice. It is easy if you practice. I'm not saying it's difficult, but then you have to practice. Otherwise, it can be quite a challenge. So reading again, the level of difficulty increases with each section. That means your first section is going to be easier than your last. The first passage should be, it's better if the first passage is assigned 15 minutes, second passage 20 minutes, and the third passage, that is a difficult passage, is assigned 25 minutes. So this way, if you prioritize your time, you will be able to complete within your 60 minutes. And for those of you who are doing paper-based test, you will be able to, you will have that extra 10 minutes to transfer your answers and once just read through it. So use that time wisely. I am repeating this once again. Please use 15 minutes for task 1, 20 minutes for task 2, and 25 minutes for task 3. This will be a very apt time allotment. Okay. Now, moving on. For each passage, allot 3 to 5 minutes to look for errors. Please do that. So that, you might write the answer, but then it's very, very important that you write the right answer, correct? So try doing that. And another very important thing that I tell most of the students is do not spend too much time on the same question, especially when it comes to true or false, not given and all. Some people just search for not given. They search so much for not given that mostly they miss out on the remaining questions. You spend all your time on one difficult question and you lose out on all the 20 easy questions. Please don't do that mistake. So don't spend too much time on the same question. If you can't find the answer, move on to the next question. You can always come back to the difficult question later. Okay. Yes. Moving ahead, let's look at writing. So writing again is one of the easy sections where you can score more. Some of them find writing difficult, but again, they find writing difficult only because, lack of practice. So in the writing section, again, you have 2 tasks. That you have task 1, which is, either a letter writing or a graph. That this letter writing or a graph, I'll tell you the difference. So you have 2 categories called general IELTS and academic IELTS. General IELTS is for those who want to go abroad to work. And academic IELTS is for those who want to go abroad to study. Okay, that is the major difference. So first decide whether you want to do the general IELTS or the academic IELTS. So this letter writing that you can see in task 1, the letter writing is for general IELTS. Whereas if you pick the academic IELTS, you will be given a graph or a line, graph, pie chart. Sometimes you will even be given a diagram.
I don't understand listening.
Can we keep the doubts for the last?
Listening.
Listening, yes. You want me to explain the listening section once again?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, once I'm done with the writing, I will go back and explain the listening.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes, you're welcome. So like I was saying, you will have bar graphs, line graphs, pie charts, and sometimes you'll even get diagrams. And this is about your academic writing task one. Whereas your writing task two is same for both academic and general. And in this, you get an essay. So you have to, you know, it's advisable that you spend 20 minutes on task one and 40 minutes on task two.
Okay, ma'am. I understand.
So why this time difference is because your task one has, you have to write only 150 words. Whereas for task two, you have to write 250 words, minimum 250 words and minimum 150 words. So it's better you allot more time for, you know, the more number of words. And comparatively, writing an essay is a little more challenging than just writing a letter or, you know, describing a graph. So it is advisable you spend 20 minutes for task one and 40 minutes for task two. Yes. Now, again, in task one, assign 3 minutes to plan. Now, many people think planning is a waste of time, but please don't consider planning as a waste of time because, you know, even if you are going to take out that 3 to 5 minutes for planning, it is going to be useful because when you're writing your essay, when you're writing your letter or your graph, you know what you're going to write. So you don't have to stop in between to think what you're going to write. So please take out that 2 to 3 minutes and plan. And then 10 minutes to write and 2 minutes to check your answer. This way, you will get extra 5 minutes. Writing your letter or your graph, basically writing 150 words in 10 minutes might sound challenging. But once you start writing a lot of essays, it becomes easy. And here at Red Fox, we do that a lot. We practice a lot. In fact, I myself practice with you. So, you know, the more we practice together, the more it is going to become easier for you. And then I can assure you that you will be able to write an, you know, a 150 word description or a 150 word letter in 10 minutes. That can be done. So moving ahead, let's look at, you know, task two. And yes, task one, basically just you have to write what you see already. Yes, the letter requires a little more effort, but the bar graph and the chart, pie chart, you just have to describe what you see. So your work is easier there. Okay, moving on to task two again. Assign 5 to 7 minutes to plan because task two can come in a lot of variety. You have 5 different types of essay questions. We will discuss in detail about the 5 different types of essay questions in another webinar. But giving you, you know, a small gist about it, you have advantages and disadvantages type question. You have problem solution type question. You have 2-part type question. Then you have an opinion-based question. And then there's another one, discussion-based question. So you have all of these categories. And it is important that you understand in everything what you do. So basically, this question type is your task. And you have marks for task achievement. So instead of, you know, in the place of an advantages and disadvantages type question, if you write a 2-part question, then you are going to lose marks in task achievement. So it is very important that you understand your task and plan accordingly. And this is where that 5 to 7 minutes help you. You might feel that, you know, why am I have only 20 minutes. Why am I wasting 5 to 7 minutes in this? So, you know, don't worry about that. Please take out that 5 to 7 minutes because that will help you write the essay later. Okay. You will not stop in between to be worried to think about what you want to write next. And in this planning process, if it helps you, each one uses different strategies. If it helps you, please take down, you know, notes somewhere on the question paper. You can scribble so that, you know, you can use those points in your essay later. So again, in this, after you have assigned 5 to 7 minutes for your planning, use 30 minutes to write the essay and 3 to 5 minutes to check your answer. I know I sound like, you know, like all, I'm telling you like a school child, please check your answer, please check your answer. But it is extremely essential for you to check your answer because when you're writing an essay, you are writing something in flow. And when you're writing something, you know, in a flow at a stretch, you will miss out a lot of words. You might tend to make spelling mistakes. you might, you know, miss out on singular, plural, you know, that S-C-S-I-E-S. So always go back and check your answer and read through it once so that you know that you have not made any mistake. After all, you don't want to lose marks because of one silly spelling mistake, right? So always check your answer. And, you know, in the time planning all of this, write down your main points, like I mentioned, so that you know what you have to write in favor of the topic and what you have to write against the topic. And it's very important, because only if you write in favor and against, you will be able to complete the 4 paragraphs that the essay requires. Yes. So speaking about this, I would like to show you. Give me a second. Yes. So this is one of our worksheets. This is what our worksheets look like. So I thought, you know, I'll take this opportunity to show you that. So this is what our reading worksheets look like. We generally, Red Fox Education doesn't believe in directly, for example, if it's supposed, you're supposed to write an essay. We don't directly make you write an essay. First you brainstorm, you understand what is going on. You go through, you know, your, you go through and you write down all the thoughts that are there in your mind. And then you put all of that into an essay. You don't just directly dive in and write an essay. Same way with reading. First, we focus on vocabulary. We understand, we read together. We, you know, try to match vocabulary with the sentences. And after that, only after that, you know, different topics. You do true, false, not given, and other things as well. Okay, multiple selection, table completion. These are all reading topics. And you can also see that there is a passage here. So this is what your passage looks like. So this is how your passage looks like. So the passage will just go on and the passage will just go on and you can just read that and you can, you know, answer all the questions. Okay. This is what your passages will look like. This is just one of the passages that I'm showing you for sample. Okay. Yes. This is what our material looks like. And about Red Fox Education. So we are an online British school. In this pandemic time, it is really, you know, an advantage that you get to do all of our courses online. So all of our courses, like I said, is available online. And along with courses, you also have a lot of material. You also have a lot of free material. You can, you know, check out our app on Play Store and App Store both. I will share the link in the chat box. So you can pick up, you know, you can just go download our app and look through the material. Now, coming to IELTS, we have 3 different courses right now. Or I would rather say 5 different courses. So the major 3 are beginners, intermediate, and advanced. So these 3 courses are for people with different proficiencies. Now, beginners course, many of you might want to give your exam. You haven't given your exam before. You want to learn about IELTS as well as you also want to study. You want to study from the basic. So the beginners course is meant for people like that. Then you have, you know, your intermediate course. And in the intermediate course, yes, and in the intermediate course, is for those. The intermediate course is for those who have given your exam before and you would like, you know, a little improvement on your band score. And also those whose language is, you know, good. And then you have your advanced course. And in this advanced course, you get a lot of tests and you get to study the last minute tips and techniques that is required to clear your examination. Along with all this, at the end of the course, we also provide you with a certification focusing on, you know, English communication. And this certificate will be very helpful whether you want to, you know, place it on your resume or whether you want to, you know, place it in your other certificate.
Ma'am, what is the time of your class?
Just a second, sir. When you want to place it, you know, in your file of certificates for your university admissions. So that is where the certificate will be very helpful. Yes, sir. What was your doubt?
What is the class? What is the time of your class?
Yes. So we have different batches running. So most probably just you could, you know, send us a text message on the given number and we would share our batch with you. And now all of these courses cost 5,000 INR. And, you know, you can just go through that. We also have offers running. So once you send us a message, we can even send you the offers. And the other two courses that I mentioned about is intensive speaking and intensive writing. These two courses are for those who want to focus only on writing or only on speaking. So these two courses are also available. It's a very short-term course and you can complete it easily. Even in these courses, you have a lot of, you know, material available. Now, the material that you will get, it will be PPTs. You will have a lot of worksheets like the one I showed you. You will also have a lot of recorded, pre-recorded videos from British tutors.
Ma'am.
Yes.
I'm from Africa. So is that possible if I can join your classes?
Yes. All our classes are online. So yes, you can join our classes. But you could just send us a message and I will share all of the details with you.
Okay.
Ma'am, please send me your link.
Yes, the link is in the chat box. Please copy it down from the chat box.
Okay, yes. Let me answer this call.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
Go ahead. Did somebody ask a question? Okay. So,
ma'am, I ask what is listening?
Listening, yes, I will come back to the listening portion and I will give you a small gist about it.
Okay, ma'am.
You know, finish explaining this. So intensive writing and intensive speaking, these courses cost ranges from 250 to 1000 INR. So you can, you know, check our website for the pricing details. You can also send us a message and we will share the pricing details with you along with the timings and the batch details. So yes, is there any doubt? Does anybody have any doubt regarding Red Fox Education?
No, ma'am, no question.
Okay. So then I'll just, you know, give you a small description on the listening once again, and then maybe, you know, we can wind up. Okay. So like I was saying, listening has 40 questions. And listening has 40 questions and you have to answer these 40 questions in four different categories. There's part one, part two, part three, and part four. Your part one is always going to be easier than your part four. Your part four is going to be the most challenging section. So you have 30 minutes to complete this. So there is a lot of chances you get lost in the, you know, process, that you have to do a lot of listening. And when a lot of listening is done, sometimes you might miss concentration. So it is very advisable that you practice a lot later. And it is not just the first time that you are going and sitting, you know, for your exam. Practice a lot. You train your mind what half an hour is and then you go. Okay. So in the first section, you will listen to a dialogue between two speakers. In section two, you will have a monologue, probably, you know, a travel guide, a tour guide, giving you, you know, details about the city. And then you will have a group discussion, mostly on an academic topic. So it is, it is easier if you go prepared that it is an academic topic. This way, you know what are the words you have to listen for. And the last section will be somebody, you know, giving a detailed explanation on a presentation or on, you know, a research topic. So this is going to be a little difficult, like I said, but then with practice, you can ace that as well. And after each section, you will have a little extra time to prepare. It is, you know, very necessary that you use that time wisely and, make yourself prepared for the next section by reading the questions. Please don't read the entire question paper. It will only confuse you. Read somewhere, you know, around the blanks so that you know what you have to listen for. This is what I had, mentioned about listening. So does anybody else have any other doubts regarding the webinar, regarding Red Fox Education, anything that you want more information on? Okay, I take this silence as no doubts.
Okay. No, I need to ask something, ma'am.
Yes.
I have this article which was talking about fluency and coherence. Can you clarify on that?
Can you repeat your question for me?
Oh, I have this article and I downloaded it on YouTube. And it was talking about the fluency and coherence. I think it falls under speaking.
Yes, fluency and coherence is for your speaking section. It's very important that you know you are both fluent and coherent when you're speaking. Fluency is basically the flow of your words. When you talk in your mother tongue, if you would have noticed, you will not stop. Your mind will give you the next word. There'll be a flow of words. That is fluency. You will not stop anywhere. There won't be any breaks. And coherence is basically how you put the words together, how words fall into place. Okay? So using the correct word in the correct place. So that is what both is about. And this is very, very necessary when it comes to your speaking exam.
Okay. So fluence and coherence is the same as grammatical range and accuracy, right? I think it sounds the same.
It's a little different. Maybe, you know, I could do another webinar with the same topic for you.
Okay, fine.
If there are any topic suggestions for a webinar, please do, you know, send a message to us and I will, you know, prepare a webinar for that as well for you.
Okay, thanks. I'm answered.
Okay. Yes, okay. So then we wind up today's session. And if there's any doubts, any, you know, when you want any further information or anything else, just send a message to the number in the chat box and we will get back to you. Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful day.